Nowadays, rugby league is at the forefront of sports that are trying to protect players from brain injuries. Head injury assessments are a regular feature in the NRL.
But there was no such thing when former Kiwi star Mark Broadhurst was making a living from the game, and now it seems the heroic deeds of his past are catching up with him. Here's Mike Thorpe.
Mark Broadhurst has spent his life making memories. You might remember some of them.
It's a brawl erupted now. Make no bones about this one. There are three separate groups fighting. Broadhurst handling Bowden out to the left. And they're going at it hammer at times, like two heavyweight fighters, these two.
First scrum, and we didn't even back down properly. And I let him have one, and he's been, obviously got the better of me.
Broadhurst down, Bowden still pumping punches into him.
Mark's been front and centre in some of our most unforgettable sporting successes.
Broadhurst, Barley, out for Kurt Sorensen, and a ball up for Rapati, and Rapati's in!
Probably beating them in Lang Park and when Graham Lowe took over the coach up there. I can't remember what year that was, it'd be 1983, probably, 82.
19-12, and there's the count.
I flew home on the same plane as half the Aussies too, so that was quite good.
Playing 17 times for his country, he's regarded as one of our toughest.
You've got to stand up for yourself in those days, especially playing prop, you know.
Wow. The crowd loving every moment of that.
Well, he's either going to belt me or I'm going to belt him, one of the two, isn't it? It was just part and parcel of the game in them days. You know, there was a lot of hair ties.
Perhaps his most famous moment was being on the wrong end of a couple of headbutts playing for Manly against Newtown in 1981.
There's Broadhurst. He's got two black eyes by the look of it.
I knew which way to go, but, you know, it was just about I couldn't really see too much.
Were you in pain?
Not when I was out there playing, no. I think I was full of adrenaline, probably pumped up for the game. And I didn't want to go off. I think I was brought up, you know, the old man used to say, never let them know you're hurt and all this sort of stuff from the old school. But it wasn't until later on that I went back to the club rooms, and then I thought I'd better get out to the hospital. You know, I obviously had a depressed fracture of the cheekbone. I still feel the bloody hole there where it was broken.
See, Mark has little problem remembering those details. In fact, he has a story for every occasion. But recently, his short-term memory has suffered.
Well, I was getting very forgetful, especially when I was with my partner and stuff, and she was picking up that, you know, I was making mistakes and what I was talking about, and I had to go and get some tests, about five brain scans I went through and got, and the end result was that they said I've got Alzheimer's.
How did that feel to hear that diagnosis?
Yeah, well, it hasn't really worried me too much. I can only do what I can do, so just carry on with my life as best I can, you know, and hopefully I don't deteriorate too much.
At 65, the bloke that feared nobody does fear losing his most precious memories.
You know, I was able to spend a lot of time with my kids when they were growing up, being over in England playing football. You know, I wasn't working, so I was there for them, especially when they were young.
There'll be plenty of people that'll watch this story and think, oh, I bet he wishes he hadn't done that.
No, I don't, no. I'm pleased that I went and did those things. I can say I did do it, and I know what it was like and what a great time it was. You know, a great part of my life.
Oh, good on you, Mark, and good on you for coming out and talking about that. I think it's a good thing to chat about.
Yeah, it's quite scary stuff. I remember, you know, former All Black halfback Steve Devine, and he had multiple head knocks, and it was quite horrendous listening to how it impacted him. He'd have friends over, and then he'd have to go to bed for 4 hours after they left. He was so exhausted. The fatigue was so bad, he wouldn't get out of bed sometimes for 2 days.
Is that right? And then he gave up professional
And
rugby.
Then he had to give up. He couldn't play anymore. He got quite depressed, and it was an awful story.
Yeah, I do worry about that sort of stuff.
Yeah.